Subscribe to Cooking and Travel by Dr. Papure Borua and press on the bell icon for all notifications. Good morning everybody and welcome back to my channel. I would like to present before you fish today, a recipe with Boreala. What we call Boreala mass, or this is a variety of small variety of fish that we have. It's found very abundantly in Assam, and we love to have a curry of with this particular fish. And in fact, I'll show you many other ways of having this fish. I have taken here around 15-20 Boreala fish, and I'm going to make a sorsori out of the Boreala fish. That is Boreala fish in mustard sauce. And it's typically, authentically Assamese, I always use that word, and something, it's so yummy that just a bowl of, you know, steamed rice is enough to have with this particular recipe. So let's start cooking this specially delicious recipe. Let me now introduce you to the ingredients. I need a paste because it's a mustard sauce. Therefore, I have taken here 2 big tablespoons of yellow mustard. I've also taken a small teaspoon of melon seeds or mogos, 1 chili and 1 just a pod of garlic. I'll also use some haldi powder or turmeric and some salt. All of these will make the paste which will form the base of this recipe. Apart from that, as I said, this is around 20 Boreala fish, and here you can choose any variety of small fish. This size is perfect. Here I have boiled 1 big potato with some salt and some water, and I need here, say, 1 small teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, one tomato which I'll grind, in a way grate and take it, and this is cut into very small pieces, 1 onion. The entire cooking will be done in mustard oil, and this is going to be a very, very yummy recipe. Let's start cooking. This is how the Boreala fish looks after just smearing with salt and turmeric and giving it a light fry in just mustard oil. It's just very, very lightly fried, and now we are ready to go. In the same oil where I had fried the fishes there, now I'm going to first of all put in the onion there. I'll fry the onion for some time and then almost immediately give in the ginger garlic paste. Ginger garlic paste also goes in, and I'll fry for some time till the raw flavor of these go away. Around this time, I'll also be giving or adding in the turmeric. This being a little tangy sort of a recipe, you need to put a little bit more of the turmeric, because otherwise the color of the turmeric really fades away. So we'll just stir in for some time and then put in the boiled pieces of potato. I'm going to crush with my hands the pieces of potato and put it. If you see, I haven't added the tomato. I'm going to add the tomato later because I still want to retain the crunch of the tomato. So this way, on medium flame, I'll fry it for some time till we have a crunch on the potatoes. So when the oil starts to separate, I'll put in the grated tomato. Fry it for some time. We don't need much time. Just increase the heat there and just continue frying. And by now, I have already boiled almost a liter of water, and that hot boiling water is going into this curry, and it's almost 50. The hot boiling water, not much, because sorsori isn't very, very watery sort of a, you know, gravy. So I'm just giving a little, as I think just half a liter. Normally when we talk about mustard paste, many people find this, you know, they come face to face with this problem when the mustard turns bitter. That's the worst nightmare of anyone who's cooking, right? So for that, I normally take one thing in mind, that you have to really grind it very, very thin, very, very fine, and also add a little bit of melon seeds or mogos so that the bitterness is cut off. Now see, while I was talking to you, this has already got the first boil. Now I'll put in the fishes there. So the fishes go in. And remember one more thing, when you're making a curry, at least in Assamese cuisine, whenever we are making a curry, we do not make the fishes, we do not fry the fishes very, very hard. Traditional Assamese cooking, normally they put the fishes without frying, but I normally don't like it without being fried a little, or the feel of being fried, and therefore I fry it. And now when it's really, you know, heating up and boiling is the time when I put in the mustard paste. I like a little bit of mustard in my dish, so I'm adding all of them in a way. And then I haven't added salt as yet. Look at the beautiful color. It's a mixture of orange and yellow and brightness there. This is the speciality of a sorcery. You know, we have this beautiful feeling of tanginess and the strong taste of mustard blending together. And I haven't used salt here, and because when we talk about using or grinding mustard, I normally add a little bit of salt there. So now I'll check in for the salt and put in the required amount of salt. If you want a little bit of spice there at this moment, you can add in, just break in one green chili and put in, otherwise it's fine. Okay, let me just check in for the salt. Yes, we'll need salt, but it's already getting the fine taste of mustard, tomato, of sorcery. So this goes in, but I think I'll need a little bit more of the heat, so I'll add one more chili. See, it's already cooked. We are not covering it, it's almost done. We normally put in the mustard paste towards the end of the recipe. We normally do not put in the beginning, so we'll not boil much after the mustard paste is put on. Now let me now just reduce the flame a bit and introduce one chili. So I'm splitting apart one chili and then putting it in. Just let it boil for some time and then it'll be done. So we'll wait for some time till it gets its boil, but we are not covering it. So this is done. See, this is the gravy I want. Not very watery, not very thick, and it's done. Look at those pieces of the fishes there. Lovely. So only steam rice is what I want now. So my Boreola Masoor sorcery is done. Look at that beautiful color. And you can imagine how tasty it will be. Let me dish out a bowl of this yummy, yummy dish there and enjoy with steamed rice. There goes, and we of course will love to crush in the chili also. So that's my dish. I hope you will love this recipe. You'll try it out. Do give it a like and a thumbs up, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Thank you so much for watching.